Hi, garden friends. Welcome to the channel. I'm Era, and this is Gardening on Purpose. If you're new here, welcome. And if you're a subscriber, welcome back. Thank you so much for taking time to watch my video. I garden in Georgia, Zone 8A, where I do gardening-related videos. Today, I'll be giving you guys a June backyard tour. Let's get started. All right, guys, so here we are in June. A lot of plants are budded up. A lot of plants are in flower. And actually, some plants have already gotten their first flush out the way, need to be trimmed and pruned so that they can get ready for their second flush. So here's the first bed that I want to show you. And you recognize this. You see the roses, the sedums, the daisies. But I want to point out mostly things that, because you've seen those before, I want to point out things that are coming through now. They're really coming through. First up is the beautiful black-eyed Susan. This one here is budded up and getting ready, so that probably will not have a bloom until maybe next week. Everything else is looking great. You've seen them before. You've seen the roses. You've seen the daisies. You might have seen this beautiful coneflower and the spotlight video. This guy here is Leotris, getting ready to give me some really nice blooms. And in the back bed, you're gonna see another Leotris that looks even just as good, actually. And look at that, guys. Speaking of the Japanese beetle, look who it is. Right there. Right there. Just wreaking havoc. I don't like spraying things, but I'm gonna have to spray, because when I show you my hibiscus, you're gonna be like, whoa, it's really, really bad. So the Leotris is getting ready to bloom. I've got another black-eyed Susan back here that is also budded up. You might have seen a dahlia video, a spotlight video. Those are in bloom. My other lilies, they are pretty much done. These lilies only bloom once and then they're done. Also want to show you this beautiful bee balm. This just started blooming like 3 or 4 days ago. And a spotlight video is coming for that. As you know, bee balm is a pollinator magnet and it is looking beautiful. Stay tuned for the spotlight video. We'll get more details about the type of bee balm that this is. Of course, the daisies looking great. Coreopsis looking great. And of course, you cannot complain at all about those knockout roses. They do what they need to do. So that's that first bed right here. I'm loving what I'm seeing. Really, really happy with that bed. On this back bed here, we have a yucca. Color Guard Adam's Needle. We've got a Puckster Periwinkle that you should have seen in a spotlight video. And also, here's another Leotris. More coneflowers. This is the Prairie Purple. And then again, in this back bed, we've got phlox that are pretty much done. This one is done, but these guys are getting ready to do their thing. All clearance plants. Mums. Balloon flower. And there's something going on with my yarrow. I don't know why the plant did this. It's getting enough sun. Don't know what's going on, but I'm gonna have to look into that when I get a spotlight video going for yarrow. This is one of the plants that did their first flush already. This is the Cat's Meow Nepeta. It needs to be pruned, deadheaded, really, so that it can get ready for its second bloom. Other things in here are sedums, more phlox, an abelia. I need to dig out this particular lamb's ear. It's taking up too much space. This beauty here is sea holly. Pollinator magnet, guys. Really, really nice. Got this beer root. The daylilies have done their first flush. They've actually had seed pods, so they might be done. And then here are some of the hibiscus that I mentioned that are getting messed up. Now, this one here is just a regular hibiscus I bought from Lowe's or Home Depot. So look at the leaves, how they're looking really, really bad. But then look at the summerific ones. These are definitely not, ooh, look at the summerific, guys. No, this is not a summerific. This is the bloomables. The bloomables one, those are looking really, really bad too. And here's the culprit right there. I know I don't want to spray, but I'm going to have to because I can't afford to let the garden look like that. Then my sunshine ligustrum, looking great, but again, just needs to be pruned. So this is the back bed. So what I started out showing you was that first bed right there. Here's the back bed with the coneflowers, the sea holly, the leotrice, and of course the hibiscus that are all messed up. Here's the third bed I want to show you. Man, the daisies are just showing off. I don't know what else to say about it, but they're just looking absolutely amazing. The coneflowers, these are the bunch of coneflowers that I have in the yard are either the Artisan Series, the Cheyenne Spirit, Pow Wow, and one other one I can't think of right now. We've got phlox that are getting ready to be, they're budded up and getting ready to bloom. We've got knockout roses, Veronicas, another hibiscus that is getting torn apart by the Japanese beetle. The Montauk daisy, which I did not include in the daisy spotlight because it was not, there was nothing happening when I did that video. It is a daisy, it's Montauk daisy, named after Montauk, New York. But here they are budded up, and these are supposed to actually bloom in cooler weather. Here we are in June, first week in June. It's really, really hot today, but the Montauk daisy, and guys, it has gotten so big. I bought this in a 2.5 quart. Those are little things that they sell at Lowe's and Home Depot. Look how big this thing is. And I had bought five of them. I actually had to give some away because I just don't have the space for this. What else looks good? We've got my queen mum agapanthus that I was worried about that wasn't going to come back, but it is going to come. It came back. And not only did it come back, it is budded up and getting ready to bloom. Here are some daylilies. A spotlight video is already out on these blanket flowers. More phlox that I got on sale that are budded up. A phlox spotlight video will be coming up soon. We've got yarrow, another type of yarrow. This particular yarrow is doing really, really great. This pastel-y, pinky-looking color, looking way better than the other one I showed you earlier. And another hibiscus that is budded up. Now, the thing is, the hibiscus is going to bloom. It's not going to stop it because, as you can see, it's all budded up everywhere. This one is going to be a beautiful red. But the foliage, guys, these Japanese beetles, ooh. The back of this bed, we have some sunshine ligustrums that, again, needs to be pruned. And I have these loropetalums, these Chinese fringe flowers in front of those. Because I extended this bed, because when I first did the yard, I was going to stop the garden here, this line, right there. So this is what was going to, I was going to make this grow really, really tall. But I realized I needed to clean that space out here so I can extend, because this is really my yard, and I was just, it was just wasted space. So what I ended up doing was I extended the bed. So by doing that, I have to trim these down to maybe 2 feet, because in the back of that is where I have even more plants, such as beer root daylilies, beautiful delphinium. Isn't this a beauty, guys? This, I got two delphiniums. This one's one right there, and this beauty right here. Don't have to worry about delphinium with critters because it is poisonous. And I have three orange rocket barberries. I've got two other hibiscus. They're not bothered yet by the beetle, but these are the proven winners. The ones I bought is a sugar tip, and the other one is pink chiffon. I believe this is sugar tip. I'm not sure because I need to do a spotlight video. I need to get the tag, but there's one right there. And this one here is blooming already. These I bought in a quart when I was going through my plant withdrawal back when things were cold and there was nothing in the stores to buy. And I went online and these were on sale. You might have seen this guy here in one of my recent clearance videos from Lowe's, where I had this. It was supposed to be coral, they said, and it looked like it was going to be coral. And I said I was going to trim this thing here so that it could come back. But before I got a chance to trim, guys, the petals opened up, so I couldn't bear to cut that off. And it's looking really, really great. There's a Japanese beetle right there again. So I had bought two roses. There was one right here and another one right here. I just stuck them here, guys. As you know, space is limited here on my property. We have got these two guys here. This is a, what kind of tree is this? I know, it's a vitex. It's a chaste vitex. And they're not getting as much sun as they need to because they're supposed to be budded up a little bit more than this. And I have two of these. These were clearance plants from Lowe's. They were $10 each. I think one was clearance and one wasn't. And that's what these are. They are budded up, but I believe that they should have been a little bit more budded up given the type of plant that they are. But I think it's a matter of me not giving them enough sun. So here's a pan of that bed I just showed you. Okay, let's go a little further down in the yard. This is the newest bed in the yard, brand new, a couple of months ago. And it's because I was just like desperate for space and I had to create something here. This, I have two daisies in here. These were from Lowe's, or I believe, or it must have been Lowe's. And this is the Proven Winners Amazing Daisies Buttercream 2. Banana cream, not buttercream, banana cream. This is a, I know this is the name of this plant. This is also, I bought this during the same time I bought those hibiscus when I was going through that withdrawal. I'm gonna put it on the screen. I can't remember it right now. Another bed to show you. We've got some Veronicas and we've got some even more beautiful coneflowers. And this guy here, the salvia, needs to be trimmed. Another bed over here, the second most recent bed here. We have more daisies and a gladiolus that's getting ready to bloom. There it is. There's one gladiolus here and one gladiolus here. And then also in this bed, I just squeezed stuff in here, guys. It's just been really, really tight. But they have some, I have some encore azaleas in here as well. Another bed I want to show you is this guy. This one here gets part sun to sun. Well, no, maybe part shade to part sun, because a lot of them are actually leaning because they are in the shade by one. And this was just because there's nowhere else to put them. What's blooming here? It's beautiful, beautiful lilies. This is Presidente. And this is beautiful. I believe this one here is Stargazer. Stargazer is way more pink than Presidente. I bought them both in the same bag. It was a mix. And guys, you know, I mean, I think everybody has lilies. And everybody probably has either Stargazer or Casablanca or even Presidente. And these things smell amazing. We've got even more lollipop verbena that are still blooming. They've been blooming since March, and they're looking really, really great. This dahlia here, I had just stuck it here. It doesn't belong here. It's too big to be in the front of the bed, but it's going to be this beautiful purple. Once it goes back to sleep, I'm going to move it and put it somewhere that makes more sense. I just stuck it there because there was just no more space to put. And then I also have some iris that already bloomed. I missed the chance to do the spotlight video on those, but they should bloom again in the fall. And then this limetta, not hibiscus, hydrangea. Okay, further down, we have, let me show you this bed first. This one here is another full sun bed with more black-eyed Susans, more salvias, and more daisies. And then over here, I want to show you my shade bed. This is shade. Once it gets to 12 o'clock, there's no more sun on this. And this is, if you're watching my video, you'll see that there's a lot going on in this bed when I first started out versus where it is now. But it's a bunch of beautiful shade plants in here, including Lyropi, Hostas, Brunnera, Pulmonaria, Heuchera, Hellebore, Carex grass, autumn fern, more hellebores, and another type of fern that I don't remember what it is, but this fern goes to sleep. This fern is a, does not go to sleep. Over here is my hosta bed. You guys might have remembered I did a whole video about wanting to have an area that was just hostas. Now they're moving quite slow because I hand water. These are not on irrigation. We have been getting rain, but not enough rain to make up, you know, to really give us some really soaking. We've been getting rain, but we need a whole day of serious rain to get these hostas going. They look okay. They haven't been growing really, really fast. Some have. I shouldn't say that. One particular one that grows fast is the Royal Standard. That was really, really small not too long ago, and that's been growing. And then all types of other hostas in here. I'm not gonna rush it. The whole plan was not to have this thing be like the most best, the greatest garden ever in a couple of months, but I definitely wanted to have an area for just hostas. All types of hostas in here. So sweet, Diana remembered, guacamole, Royal Standard, Patriot, Bedazzled, First Frost, Rainforest Sunrise, Elegans, absolutely beautiful. And of course we have my favorite, which is Stained Glass, and we have August Moon too. Over here we have my hydrangeas. You guys know I love macrophylla particular. So here we have a combination of Bloomstruck, Summer Crush, Heartthrob, the original by Endless Summer, Penny Mac, and I think I got one more. What is the one more that I have? Well, these I got on clearance, these two right here, the other day. Oh, that's what it was. This was Merit Supreme, and these just went in the ground like maybe a week and a half ago, so there's nothing really to really see here. They were clearance plants. They look really, really rough. And then further up, guys, are a part sun to shade plants such as azaleas that bloom once a year. And then we have foxglove. Got a couple of foxgloves the other day from Walmart, and the pollinators love them. It's so cute to see the bee climb into the foxglove. Look at that. He's in there. He's in there, guys. So that's the shade area. Foxgloves don't like, they need some sun, but they don't want to be in blazing sun. And of course, here in Georgian Zone 8A, we definitely do not want to have certain plants out in the sun after 12 o'clock. Here's a table of some plants that I've shown you before. Some I've shown you before, some I haven't. This is the Proven Winners banana cream daisies that I needed for my project. And then I need to do a video of me showing you some other plants that I bought. further down in the yard, guys. This is like me making my way down through the gate to go to the front. This is where I have a couple plants that I'm still deciding what to do. You might have seen my video where I bought this beautiful spider's web fascia. And at first I said I was going to put this outside, but guys, I splurged on this. This was $32, so I don't think I'm going to take the risk and have this plant outside. I will probably put it on the patio. And then this beautiful Goldust Akuba, this Elysium here, and more Fatsia. I've got some, these guys here, the plan was to put them in the ground, and then I realized I need to get some more, some more stuff to put in the ground, compost and pine bark before I put it in the ground. So I ended up putting it in here to hold it. These are the Mountain Snow Pieris. I had four of these on clearance from Lowe's, and they're looking great. These are shade plants. So this is the gate to go outside to the other side of the yard, which you've seen. You might have seen a video where I did a tour of the side yard. So that's the side yard right there. But this is once you come through that gate. Mostly shade over there, and then you walk in, and then this is my yard, guys. I also wanted to give you an update on the edible garden, so let's head that way. But before we do, this is the path, this is the arbor, and I have my wisteria on it. Wisteria will die back, but hopefully next year. It's been taken good to the arbor. It has, but because of the way wisteria is, I want it to give me more. I want to give me more, and hopefully it does, so I don't have to move it. Here are some containers. I need to kind of trim this area, so excuse the little messy mess here. I have two Meyer lemons that I've never really gotten lemons from, and all of a sudden, guys, I've got a bunch of lemons on here. I'm so happy about it. I might be actually able to make lemonade. Look at that. Look at this big lemon right here. Here's another one here, another one. So only one of the two actually has lemons. So hopefully when things get really, really hot, we know citrus likes the heat, they will give me more lemons so I can actually make lemonade and be proud of the fact that I bought these things 2 years ago and I'm finally getting a lemon from it. Then we have my Japanese maples. This one is winter red. This is an Acer palmatum. And this one here is a Katsura. This one here, I believe, is Oregon Sunset. I had like an extra Sunshine Ligustrum that I just put in a container. Look at my cherry tree, guys. Look at all those Japanese beetles just having a field day on this thing. Definitely, definitely gonna have to spray this thing. Then I have my peach tree here. I won't get a peach. I already know that. I've tried to protect this tree. It doesn't seem to matter. These chipmunks and these squirrels are just running amok in my yard. But I'm just going to keep the peach tree. Instead of trying to have peaches to eat, just make it be like a flowering tree, you know, and just be done with it. Or else I'm actually going to go nuts if I try to fight these critters. Because you know what? To be honest with you, they were here before me, you know, even though I pay the taxes here and I pay the mortgage. They were here before me. Okay, what else I want to show you? Here, we're going to build a raised bed. I can't wait. So that's what this area is for. These are actually some hanging baskets that I had to take off of the shepherd's hook to mow the lawn. So that's why they're there. But those are not going to be actually what's going to actually end up there. They were more behind this area here, which is what I had planned out for my white garden. Now, guys, other than the plants I already have in the yard, I really want to get different types of plants for the white garden. And it's been really hard finding plants other than daisies, other than coneflowers, and anything else that's white. I would love to get some different types of white. Now, one I already had in here was this iris here, which is going to end up staying here. And this is the Immortality Bearded Iris. This was white, so that will stay here. But otherwise, it's pretty much empty, guys. I'm just looking for plants. I've got a rose in here. I've got an iceberg rose. And didn't know where to put these guys here, these Leland cypress, but they're just gonna stay here as just to have something as a structure. And then I put, in desperation, I put some two autumn lilies in here, but I don't like the fact that they're the ones in here. Then I have some peonies. One is white and one is red. So the red one can't stay here. So that's another thing too. So I'm happy with what I ended up doing with creating the bed. Because if you know, at first I was gonna make this an in-ground garden, but this area is a little bit too wet. And of course, the critters. So I decided to design it this way and then create it and make it a container garden. So if you have any suggestions other than daisies, other than hydrangeas, other than coneflowers, other than guara, which I already have, what else is out there that I could use in the white garden? Maybe some white yarrow, which I have never seen, but I know they're out there, you know, and something that can take my zone. So that's that. So then this is the rest of the yard, guys. Let's go up, finally up there where I had to clean out the extension area. Oh, and also I want to show you the roses. I had trimmed these back. They gave me their first flush. I trimmed them back and they are all coming back. Look at this beautiful Rio Samba here. It's all budded up. These are Walmart roses, guys. $9.97. And Walmart bought these in February and they're all doing great. More roses here. And they are looking fabulous. Got some butterfly bush. These are the ones that grow really, really big. More daylilies. More roses and more butterfly bush. Look how big this thing gets, guys. Clearance plant 2 years ago that was measly and looking rough, and this thing is living its best life. Okay, back here, you might have seen another video not too long ago where I gave you an update on what I was doing in the back of the yard. If you remember, like I said, this is the main garden, right? This is the main garden. But when things got really, really tight, I got desperate and was like, I need to clean the back of my yard so I can make more space to plant more stuff, right? So I come back here, and back here is where my ditch is. You guys, the famous ditch is where the property line ends, where it fills up with water when we get really, really bad rain and the water spills over into my yard. But this was literally just brush, guys. And I came out here and I cleaned it up and it opened way more space for me to put more stuff. Look at all these stuff I already have in here. A bunch of clearance plants and everything. I've got Camiocyparis, I've got Indian Hawthorn, I've got Lyropi, Hostas, Akubas, a bunch of hookeras and hostas around this tree, and even more shade. So this is shade to part shade. No sun further up here. And back there is the ditch. And then of course that's the property line. But yeah, this is that extension area that I worked on. And in desperation, I had nowhere else to put these guys here, these red hot pokers. So they do get a little bit of a sun, just a little bit, enough to give me some sort of bloom. This area here is where the water spills over into the yard. So all I can do here is just keep this area trimmed. I can't plant anything here because when the water comes from there, comes out here, goes this way, floods my yard, and makes a whole mess. At least 3 to 4 times a year this happens. So nothing can actually grow here. So that's why that area looks like that. But I did end up putting some canna lilies in here because they like water and, you know, nothing else can go there, so I'm not gonna stress about it. Then we have a bunch of Lyropes underneath this tree. This bed needs to be de-weeded, seriously de-weeded. But look at the area that I worked on, that I cleaned up. I'm really, really happy with it. So the plan is to keep this way, keep this trimmed, clean out all these weeds and leave the canna lilies alone, and just keep this bed looking really, really great. Finally, guys, I'm walking towards the edible garden and I can already see why I need to water these guys. Oh my God, I need to water them. They're in grow bags. So grow bags, that's one thing. I like the grow bags, but the downside to grow bags are that they dry out really, really fast. And unless you have consistent rain, you need to water grow bags at least three times a week, which I have not been doing because I hand water. And there are times when I just do not want to do it. So my peppers came out. They're looking great. My green beans, I actually have green beans, guys. Look at that. I actually have green beans. So I'm happy about that. And I have a bunch of them. One, two, three, four. I've got cucumbers and pumpkins and cantaloupes. They're doing great. Once I see a flower, I know behind every flower should be a fruit. So long as I keep feeding it and watering it. Got a squash here. Oh, here's the cantaloupe. I need to pull one of these out because they're going to be fighting for, well, two of them, fighting for food. So that's those right there. And I just put these on here because I knew once they started growing, they're going to need some support. The strawberries came out swinging, guys, but the critters beat me to it. I didn't get to actually eat any of the strawberries. The potatoes are here. They're beginning to look kind of ready, but I think it's more of watering versus that they're nowhere close to ready. Then we've got an okra here. Love me some okra. I've got two okra plants. Three okra plants. And more strawberries here. And some corn. Corn are heavy, heavy feeders, and I ran out of fertilizer, so I need to go get some. So that is the edible garden. I know it needs to be watered, but it'll come back. We're really, really hot, and even if you water it, the thing is going to droop anyway because we're in Georgia. So this is the yard, guys. I'm really, really happy with it. Took a lot of work. Took a lot of me coming out here every single day and doing a little bit of something. Don't have to do everything one time, but doing a little bit of something every day, you will definitely see the difference as the days go by. Let me know what you think of my yard, guys. Again, I'm in Georgia, Zone 8A. Please like, please share, please subscribe, and remember to hit the notification bell to be alerted on my new videos. Thank you so much for all your comments, for all your likes, and all your suggestions. I truly appreciate it. Have a great day. Bye-bye.